Praise God. Good morning. Out there, buenos dias in there. Gracias a todos los que nos están sintonizando on Facebook. Everybody who's watching on Facebook, God bless you guys there, wherever you're at too. Just hang with us, man. We're just going to have a service about an hour long, como una hora. We're going to praise God a little bit. Vamos a alabar a Dios poquito. Get into the word, la palabra. And then you can go home and finish celebrating over there. Amen. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you all for being here. Gracias a ustedes por estar aquí. Bendiciones.
Yeah, my turkey's great. Jesus. Yes, Father, we praise you. We worship you, Father. We glorify your holy name.
Así eres tú, así.
Good morning to the some of the motorcycle communities here this morning. My brothers from Honor Bound, amen, and Tribe of Judah's here this morning. Praise God, amen. All right, amen. Jesus, amen. Praise God, amen. Well, it's good to be here this morning. Oh, Rosie's here, amen. Amen. It's good to be here this morning. Praise God. And thanks for coming out and braving the wind and the snow and the rain and the sleet and the hail and everything to be here this morning. And thank God that he gave us some beautiful weather this morning. And God is just good. Amen. He's just a good God. He's an awesome God. And we just serve him. We serve him. And that's what he's called us to do. He's called us to serve him. Serve him. You know, that's why when we come to Jesus, as from what I can see, all of you know Jesus, amen. So when you came to Jesus, you know, What did you do? You know, you surrendered your heart to Him. You opened up your heart. You know, it's like I was telling them during the midweek service online that, you know, you can surrender your legs, you can surrender your hands, you can surrender your eyes, you can surrender whatever. Amen. But if you don't give Jesus your heart, you haven't given Him anything. Amen. This is all about the heart. Amen. Everything has to do with our heart, you know. And I remember as I see the police officer driving by there, thank you, Jesus, for our police department. But I remember back in the day when I used to have to put my hands up, and then that happened not on occasion. It used to happen all the time. You know, I'd get arrested or fixing to get questioned, and I was asked to put my hands up. I would put them up, you know, out here. But my heart was not surrendered. You know what I'm saying? You know, inside I was calling them all kinds of names. I was cussing them out. You know, they were this and they were that. And, you know, so my heart wasn't there. You know, I was just raising my hand because I had that pistol pointing at me, you know? And that's why I say it's the same thing. If you don't surrender your heart, amen? A lot of people want to surrender to Jesus, but they don't want to surrender their heart. And that's where, according to Proverbs chapter number 4, That's where the issues of life flow from, man. That's who we are. You know, what flows from our heart, it actually defines us, amen? Well, no, Jesus defines me. Well, where do you think He lives, amen? He lives in your heart through the Holy Spirit. So therefore, who we are in our heart, that's who defines who we are, amen? And no matter how much, you know, we can show it on the outside, but you know what? It's what comes out here, amen? And I've told the church this before. You know, we listen and we hear, and you know what? And the way that God set this body up and all of our bodies, the way He set it up, you know what? It comes in, it transmits, and it comes to the heart. As David Wilkerson wrote one time, our mind is the womb to the heart. So whatever we're thinking, whatever we're allowing, and, you know, we don't allow the our helmet of salvation and our shield of faith to block that stuff out, amen, then guess what? You know, that stuff comes into our heart, and when it comes into our heart, it settles there, and eventually it gives birth in our heart. And then what happens? It comes out of our mouth. It comes out of our lives. So therefore, out of the abundance of the heart speaks the mouth. Amen? So that's why I'm opening up with that this morning. You know, it has to be the heart, guys. It has to be. We have to give Jesus our heart. Our heart has to belong to Jesus. That's why we've been encouraging you to ask God and talk to God and tell Him, yo, God, you know, come into my heart and shake me, shake me, shake me of everything that doesn't belong there. Shake me of everything that's in the way of me having that relationship that you require of me. You know, shake everything that's a stumbling block to my prayer life, to my Bible reading, to me getting closer to you. Just shake me. You know what? And actually, that's a very daring challenge. That's a very daring prayer to ask God. Why? Because if you ask God to shake you, amen, He's going to shake you. You ask God to shake your heart, He's going to shake your heart. That's what He's going to do. Because you know what? That's what He wants to do. He wants to have not just a piece of our heart. He wants to have all of our heart. He doesn't want to have just, you know, a little corner over here on the side. Okay, Jesus, you know, when you let Him in, you know, everybody else, you know, we ain't got that much room. You know, kind of like at the inn, you know, when Mary was going to give birth to Him, you know, there was no room at the inn for Him. And that's the way you treat your heart sometimes. So you want to send Him to the stable. Send Him over there to the stable. Jesus, I ain't got room for You in my heart. You know, there's all kinds of stuff going on. I got all kinds of things in there. Why don't you go to the stable here in my heart? I got some stables over here. I got one there for you. Amen. So, you know, we'll lay out some brand new straw for you, and you can hang out there. You can kick back right there. And if I need you, I'll call you. You know, it doesn't work like that. You know, it doesn't work. You know, yeah, if we need Jesus, we can call on Him. Yeah, that's biblical. He wants us to. Come unto me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I shall give you rest. Amen. That's what He tells us. But you know what? It's not just when you need Jesus. It's not just when I need Jesus. You know what? Okay, I'm doing my thing all day long, 24/7, up and down. Oh, here comes a little trial, a little tribulation. Uh-oh, I'm feeling a little sick. Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you. I'm going to feel safe to say this morning that I believe that kind of hurts his feelings. It really does. You know why? Because, you know, I look at myself as a father, you know, the father of my children. our daughters, you know, and we have a pretty chill relationship. We okay, you know, but, you know, I know I would feel bad as a dad that if they just came to me when they needed something and not any other time. You know, any other time they're out living and doing their own thing, and then they don't come to me for anything, and then all of a sudden they need something, so they call Pops. I believe that would hurt my feelings. You know, it's like, yo, what's up, girl? You know, I got three daughters, right? So, you know, what up? You know, you come in like this. You know, you never come see me. You never come talk to me. You know, you never call. I try to call you. You never answer your phone. You tell me, your father, to text you. You know, what's up? And now you need something, and now you come to me. So I believe that, you know what, I would kind of call him on a check on that one. And I believe that God would do that. And, you know, yeah, he is a loving God. I know that. He is a merciful God. I know that. He is a compassionate God. I know that. He is a forgiving God. I know that. That's why I'm standing here today, because I mark D, all of the above. Amen? That's
Amen.
Why. Por eso es que puedo estar aquí en esta mañana. That's why I
am
here. Por eso puedo estar aquí en esta mañana. Amen? Because of God's mercy, por la misericordia de Dios.
Amen.
Amen? So therefore, we need to come to him. Our heart needs to belong to him. Nuestro corazón tiene que ser de él. And I'm sorry, Spencer, I forgot I was doing this bilingual. But anyway, that's what happens when you turn 62. You forget things. Amen? Praise God. But anyway, I wanna read a scripture. We're not going to hold you too long. Vamos a leer una escritura. Si tienes tu Biblia, ábrela. La voy a leer en inglés. Yo, I'm going to read it in English. So if folks have it in Spanish, they can open it on their phone or whatever. But it says in Philippians chapter 4, and it talks about the true peace of God. Habla de la verdadera paz de Dios. And in nuestra vida, in our life. And it says in Philippians chapter 4, starting at verse 6 through verse 9, Filipenses 4, de 6 a 9. I'm going to read it in English. It says, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, and some Bible says all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Verse number 8. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is of good repute, if there is any excellent, if anything worthy of praise, dwell on these things. Man, he gives us a whole list. Nos da toda la lista. It says dwell on these things. You know, dice que... entreganos por decir nuestro pensamiento en eso. And it's a trip because he says to dwell on something. And you know, sometimes we tell people, dijimos a gente, no te claves, don't quit dwelling on that. Cut it loose, let it go, you know? Because sometimes, you know, stuff happens in our life, cosas pasan en nuestra vida. And we dwell on things, you know, maybe in our marriages, in nuestros matrimonios, you know, something happens between a couple, algo pasa entre la pareja, and you know, somebody was offended, alguien fue ofendido, whatever, but then we dwell on it, well, hey, y ahí estamos clavados, you know, it's kind of like one of those, back in 1941, you did this to me. You know what I'm saying? En el 1941, me hiciste esto. You know, we dwell on things. We dwell on what's incorrect sometimes. Lo que no es correcto, ahí nos clavamos. And you know what? The Bible, Jesus, God, through his Holy Spirit, through the hand of Paul, por la mano de Pablo, el Espíritu Santo did what? He gave us a list of things to dwell on. Nos dio una lista de cosas en que nos claváramos, en que depositáramos nuestros pensamientos, en que depositáramos nuestra vida. We are supposed to deposit our life in this list. How many of you say amen this morning?
Yes!
Come on, you can do better like that for Jesus. You can hide it for me. You can do that. Some of our neighbors got a hangover. We don't want to wake them up. All right, come on. Amen. So anyway, we love our neighbors. Don't take me wrong. But anyway, here we go. So what do we want to have? You know, it says, the things you have learned and received and heard, verse 9, and seen in me. This is Paul talking. Practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you. You know, who doesn't want God with you? En el versículo 9 dice que si practicas estas cosas, que Dios va a estar contigo.
¿Quién no quiere a Dios con él? Who doesn't want God with him? Man, a person's got to be a fool not to want Jesus.
Amen.
Una persona tiene que ser una persona necia para no querer a Jesús. But if you want God with you, if I want God with me, si tú quieres a Dios contigo y yo quiero a Dios conmigo, tenemos que clavarnos en esto. We have to dwell on these things, man. And you know, we got to chew it and swallow it, masticarlo y tragárnoslo. Think about it, go to bed, thinking about it, costarte, pensar. You know what? You know why you dwell on things? Because if you know this, ¿sabes por qué te clavas en cosas? Because you know that if you dwell on something and if you beg to differ, that's your problem. But if you dwell on something, eventually what you're dwelling on takes over. Si tú te clavas en algo, y no tienes que estar de acuerdo conmigo, pero con tiempo eso viene y hace que toma control de tu vida.
Amen. Like,
whatever you dwell on, that's what's going to take over.
That's right.
Hello. So that's why the Bible tells us the opposite. La Biblia nos da lo opuesto. It gives us from what the world offers. Nos da lo opuesto de lo que el mundo ofrece. It tells us to dwell on these things. Hallelujah. Que nos clavemos en estas cosas. So what happens? Amen. You know that if we dwell on things, that's what's going to take over. God is going to be with us. Dios va a estar con nosotros.
Amen.
Because we're walking in His Word. We're being obedient to His Word. Somos obedientes a su palabra. Hello. Come on now.
Amen.
Amen. Who's in this? Yes. Amen. So anyway, as we read this, you know, we see that you know, everybody wants a peace of mind. Todos quieren paz en su mente. You know, you don't want your brain racked with all kinds of stuff. No quieres que tu mente, you know, esté como una mesa de carbona, amen, just botando por todos lados. Amen. So, you know, you want to be free to do what? To enjoy your family, for one. ¿Quieres ser libre para qué? Para disfrutar tu familia. Para disfrutar tus amigos. To have a good relationship with your friends, with your co-workers, con tus co-trabajadores. And everybody you come in contact with, your relatives, you know, tus seres queridos, todos con los que vienes en contacto. You want to have a good relationship with ellos. You know, and sometimes when we don't have a good peace of mind, and you know, things are bugging us, y en veces cuando no tenemos paz, ¿verdad? What happens? What happens? Sometimes we get a little angry. Nos ponemos, nos hacemos enojones. We get mad. We have a face like you know, you got baptized, and I can't say the word, amen, but you look like that. Hello. Se mira como te bautizaron en algo que no puedo decir la palabra. And you don't want that. Tú no quieres eso. I don't want that. Yo no quiero eso. And most of all, that's why God gives us these instructions in His Word. Dios nos da estas instrucciones en su palabra. Because most, foremost important, He doesn't want that for us. Él no tiene eso para nosotros. So what does that tell us? That if He tells us to dwell on these things, que se dice que nos clavemos en estas cosas, then what? That just goes to show how much He cares for us. Que tanto le importa de nosotros. How much He wants those things out of the way. That's why He wrote them. Because He doesn't want anything hindering our relationship with Him. Porque Él no quiere nada. Por eso lo escribió estas cosas. Porque no quiere nada que se entremeta a perturbar nuestra relación con Él. Hello.
Amen. Yes. Yes.
Praise God. So, you know, I know we're in a very interesting situation in the whole world today. Sé que estamos en una situación muy interesante, and it's affecting the whole world, you know, and y'all know this, you know, ustedes saben esto. You know, this is something that plagued the whole world. Esta plaga, esta pandemia, it affected the whole world. It's affecting the whole world. Está afectando todo el mundo. And I know there's a lot of uncertainty out there. Hay mucha incertidumbre. You know, every day there's people worrying about this. Están preocupados, esto, wondering, what the heck? What's going on? You know, I hear the prophet saying this and this person saying that. Oigo que los profetas diciendo esto y otros diciendo aquello. Man, you know what? I just don't know who to believe anymore. Ya no sé quién creerle. Well, that's why the Bible says to focus on Jesus. Amen. To put your eyes on Him. Por eso dice la Biblia que te enfoques en Cristo Jesús y que pongas tus ojos sobre Él. Amen. You know, as I was saying, I think I said it last week, lo dije la semana pasada, as Christians, como cristianos, yeah, things come that bring fear, hay cosas que traen temor en veces, but you know what, as Christians, como cristianos, we are not to live in fear, no debemos de leer en temor, because whether we stay or we go, we're with Jesus, nos quedamos o nos vayamos, estamos con Cristo Jesús, amen?
Yes.
So, you know, don't be afraid. As they used to say in the hood, don't be a chicken. That's the way they say chicken in El Paso, chicken. I don't know if you've heard it. Oh, that's a chicken. Amen. Eso no se traduce, that don't translate, so let's move on. But anyway, we got a few more minutes, not that many, but let's go. Anyway, so God wants you to have true peace from worry. Él quiere que tengas una verdadera paz de que de la preocupación, de la angustia, de la ansiedad. Amen. Él quiere eso. He wants you to have that. Amen. He's even given commands in the Word of God. Nos ha dado mandamientos en la palabra de Dios. De say what? You know, check out. Look at what he told a man in Mark 3:5, in Marcos 3:5. Dijo, stretch forth your hand. Le dijo, estira la mano. But the man couldn't, no podía. He couldn't do it, amen. Yet he obeyed and he did it. Lo obedeció y lo hizo, amen. That's the key there. He obeyed and he couldn't, but he did. So there we go. So the Holy Spirit in us, el Espíritu Santo dentro de nosotros, amen. Remember, the Holy Spirit is what empowers us to be faithful.
Amen.
El Espíritu Santo es el que nos da poder para ser fiel. You know, faith to who? Fiel a quién? Well, faithful to Him. Fiel a Él. And let me tell you something, babe. It pours out to everything else you do. Everything that I do. Se brota en todo lo que haces y en todo lo que tú haces, todo lo que yo hago. Why? Because if you're faithful to God, you will be faithful everywhere else.
Amen.
Si tú eres fiel a Dios, vas a ser fiel donde quiera. You'll be faithful on your job, en tu trabajo. You'll be faithful in your marriage, en tu matrimonio.
Amen.
You'll be faithful to your children, con tus hijos, vas a ser fiel. You'll be faithful to your parents, a tus papás. You'll be faithful at school, vas a ser fiel en la escuela. In other words, you know, that's fruit, baby. Esas fruta. Amen. Es fruto. You know, so if you produce, let the Holy Spirit produce the fruit of faithfulness in your life. Si tú dejas que el Espíritu Santo produzca el fruto, amen, en tu, de fe en tu vida, then you will be faithful in everything you do. Vas a ser fiel en todo lo que hagas.
Amen. Yes.
You know? It says the withered man, he probably couldn't stretch out his hand. He probably couldn't do it. But he just obeyed. Dice que el hombre no podía estirar la mano. Amen. Pero lo hizo. He just obeyed. And there's a lot of things that you and I can't do. Hay muchas cosas que tú y yo. When God called me to do all this, cuando Dios me llamó, I couldn't do it. No lo podía hacer. You know, not because I was a chicken. No porque era gallina. No porque era un rajado, not because I was a coward. No, I just didn't know anything about this. No sabía nada de esto. But God called me out, man. Dios me llamó y dijo, órale, vámonos, let's go. Hit it, man. You got to work for Jesus. You got to work for me. Tienes que trabajar por mí. And this is what you're going to do for me. I had no intentions of pastoring a church ever. No tenía intenciones de pastorear una iglesia nunca. I didn't know how. No sabía cómo. And I still don't know how. I no sé cómo. So, in my thinking, in mi pensar, I couldn't do it. No lo podía hacer. But you know what? I responded in obedience. Amen. To the speaking of the Holy Spirit to my heart, respondí en obediencia al Espíritu Santo hablando mi corazón. And guess what? The Holy Spirit has empowered me to do work for the kingdom. El Espíritu de Dios me ha empoderado para hacer el trabajo para el reino de Dios. So you don't have to know how. Amen. You know, I didn't go to cemetery, I mean seminary. Yo no fui al seminario. I mean, I'm not the people who do go. Bless you, God bless you, praise God. If you go to seminary, Bible school, my daughter graduated from Bible school. Hey, go for it, Dad. Hallelujah. You know, dale. But I didn't go. Yo no fui. So I kind of felt kind of incompetent. I said, you know, Lord, I've read some books and things. I've leído libros. I see how so-and-so does it. Miro cómo le hace este y aquel. And, you know, I checked them things out. You know, and God just assured me. He gave me all the peace that I needed in my heart. Me dio toda la paz. But I said, don't dwell on that. No te claves en eso. Dwell on what I'm telling you. Clávate en lo que yo te estoy diciendo. And hello, here you have me in person and living color. Aquí me tienes en persona y a todo color. Hello, to God's glory, para la gloria de Dios. You know, sometimes people even tell me, you know, you're a pastor? Yeah, really, still today, I've been doing this for several years now, for muchos años y todo. ¿Tú eres pastor? You? You're a pastor? You know, yeah, I guess I am, you know. Well, why? Because God said so, that's why. Porque Dios dijo. You know, so I responded to a calling. Respondí a un llamamiento. And I'm not special. No soy especial. God has a calling for everybody. Dios tiene, for one, He called us out of Egypt, symbolic to the world. Nos llamó de Egipto, simbólico al mundo. So everybody has a calling. That's why you don't see me walking around here. No, no, mira, a mí caminando like, I got a calling and you don't. No, everybody's got a calling. Just, you know, you have to respond. Tienes que responder. And if you're waiting for something to respond, y si estás esperando algo. Now, some folks are obligated to wait. Like some of my brothers over here who are in the military. You know, they gotta comply with Uncle Sam. That's all there is to it. Como mis amigos acá que están en el militar. Now, that kind of waiting, you have to wait. But within their waiting time, pero dentro de su tiempo de esperar, they have a calling, tienen un llamamiento. So where they're at, donde ellos están, they preach Jesus there. Predican a Cristo ahí. Amen. I'm over there. Amen. Okay. And then for the full-time calling, y luego para tiempo completo, well, you know, what are you waiting on? Well, I'm waiting for this, and I'm waiting for that. And you remember when we were growing up, no es que estoy esperando esto. What would mom and dad say? What would they say? What you waiting on? ¿Qué estás esperando? Get over there, man. Get over there and start doing what I told you to do. Levántate y empieza a hacer lo que te dije que hicieras. What do you mean you waiting on something? ¿Qué estás esperando algo? That's what I used to tell the police when I was on the corner waiting for drugs. Get out the corner. We already told you. Hold on, man. I'm waiting for something. Yeah, beep, beep. You know, we have to respond to God. Tenemos que responder a Dios. You know, whatever your calling is, I don't know. Lo que sea tu llamamiento, yo no sé. But I know this for a fact. Sé esto por hecho, que you do have a calling. Tienes un llamamiento.
Amen.
You know, God does have something for your life. Dios sí tiene algo para tu vida. He's got a plan and a purpose for your life. Tiene un plan y un propósito para tu vida. Don't let nobody look down on you about that. No dejes que nadie te vea para abajo. Don't let nobody be condescending with you about that. No dejes que nadie sea condescendiente contigo de eso. You have a calling. Tienes un llamado. Because the same Bible that placed a calling on me is the same Bible that's out there for everybody who wants a calling. Hello. Amen. Amen. That's why God gave us His own. Amen. Look at what it says in Matthew. Let's get back to the worry part. I just felt I had to say that this morning. Vamos a la, vaya Mateo 6, 25 y 27, 34, 31, 34. Okay, we're going to read Matthew 6, 25, 27, 31 to 34. It says, 6:25. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is it not life more important than food? Well, you can't tell by looking at some of us, huh? And the body more important than clothes? Who of you, by worrying, can add a single hour to his life? So do not worry, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear? 32. Look at what Jesus, man, compares us to. For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. That's interesting, huh? Es muy interesante. You know, when we're worrying about these things, the Bible compares us to the unsaved. Los compara a los que no son salvos. It says the pagans go around worrying about these things. Hello, that's what it says. So he says, God knows what you need. Before you even ask him, he knows what you need. Antes de que le preguntes a Dios, él sabe lo que necesitas. So here we go. And look at that. Everybody uses verse 33. I do, you do. Todos usan el versículo 33, but nobody ever reads the upper scriptures, the pre-scriptures to that. It says, but seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Dice, buscar primero el reino de Dios y su justicia, y todas estas cosas serán añadidas. That's what it tells you. That's what it tells me. God is not a liar. Dios no es un mentiroso. If he tells us to seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto us, that's exactly what he means. Si nos dice en su palabra, buscar primero mi reino y toda mi justicia, y todas estas cosas serán añadidas, entonces exactamente eso es lo que quiere decir. That's exactly, he means what he says. Es tan serio lo que dice. That's word of God. Es palabra de Dios. Those are kingdom principles. Son principios del reino. Hallelujah. So if he says to focus on him, he will provide. Si dice que focus, no para su fin, he's going to do it. Then verse 34. It says, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. For tomorrow will worry about itself. Oh, come on now, Jesus. What are you, Jesus? He tells me not to worry about tomorrow. He says, let tomorrow be worried about tomorrow. You focus on me. Deja que mañana se preocupe de mañana. Tú enfócate en mí. You seek my face. And you know what is so true? You know, I gave a testimony last week, and we're going to start to wind it down here pretty quick. Vamos a empezar a cerrar. But, you know, I think for a lot of us, para muchos de nosotros, we've been able to really seek the Lord, you know, during this lockdown. We're out in the yard right now. All right, we need a handball court. That'll be just like prison. But anyway, amen. But, you know, I don't remember if I said it online or I told you guys last week. No sé si last week I told you this. Remember what I told you last week? Recuerda lo que te dije la semana pasada. 5 years ago, hace 5 años, I did a funeral for a friend. Hice un funeral para un amigo. His sister passed away suddenly. Su hermana, ella falleció de repente. And this was 5 years ago, hace 5 años. And he asked me to do the funeral. And I did it out of the goodness of my heart, lo hice de mi corazón. And if you want me to do your funeral, I won't charge you either. Si quieres que haga tu funeral, no te cobro tampoco, no. But I didn't charge him. That was never a thought, not even the back burner of my mind. Nunca fue un pensamiento de cobrarle, que una ofrenda, an offering, nothing. I did it because he's my friend. Lo hice porque es mi amigo. And so the funeral came and went, you know, vino el funeral y todo. Me pusieron. And last week, la semana pasada, you know, I was praying to the Lord. First of all, let me tell you that, estaba hablando al Señor about, I needed some needs. I have some needs that need to be met. Tenía las necesidades que tenían que ser encontradas. So I got a text from him. Me manda un texto. And he says, hey, Bobby, you know, what's your address? You know, I need to send you a check. Bobby, ¿qué es tu domicilio? Tengo que mandar un cheque. And I was like, I thought, because my wife does her income taxes, mi esposa hace los taxes de ellos, I thought maybe he was going to send a check to pay for his taxes, que le iba a pagar a mi esposa. That's what I thought. So, you know, a few days go by, pasan unos días, and I go out to the mailbox, and guess what? There's an envelope with my name on it. You know, I respect my wife's mail. I don't open it. I don't. She respects my mail. You know, that's just what we do at our house. Y tiene un sobre, ahí le puso con mi nombre. And it's from him. He has it. I go, wow, he addressed it to me. I go, wow, that's weird. Y me lo puso a mí. So I opened up the envelope, lo abrí, and there was a money order in there. And you know, money orders don't bounce. You know, that's good cash right there. Y era un giro. Y tú sabes que los giros no botan. And I looked at it. And it was a decent offering. Era una ofrenda decente, and a real nice letter, una carta bien bonita. Hey, you know, forgive me. You know, I should have gave you something back then. This is 5 years later. What is my point in this? God blessed me. He answered my prayers. I sought the kingdom of God first and all His righteousness. Busqué primero el reino de Dios y toda su justicia. 5 years later, I get a check. 5 años después, me mandó un cheque. You know what that tells me? And that's what should tell you. ¿Sabes qué me dice eso a mí? ¿Y qué te debe decir eso a ti? You keep seeking God's kingdom. Tú sigue buscando el reino de Dios. Keep seeking His righteousness. Sigue buscando su justicia. God doesn't forget.
Amen.
Even if it's 5 years later, God doesn't forget. Aunque sea 5 años después, a Dios no se le olvida. Just keep doing what you're supposed to do. Sigue haciendo lo que debe de hacer. Hello, come on now.
Amen.
And give me about 5 minutes, dame 5 minutos, and we'll be about done. The Bible says in 1 Peter 5:7, la Biblia dice, Pedro 5:7, he said, cast all your anxiety, hello, on Him because He cares for you. Dice que deposites toda tu ansiedad en Él. Real simple. Why? Why should you do that? It doesn't say because you trust Him, que porque confías en Él, because you believe, porque crees. You know what it says? Because He cares for you. Porque le importa de ti. He cares for what bothering you. Le importa que es lo que te molesta. He cares about what brings anxiety to your life. Él cree, él importa de ti que es lo que te trae ansiedad. He cares about you. Le importas. You matter to Him. Hello.
Amen.
You know, I know. I forgot what it was, but you know, there was just a lot going on in the United States. Había mucho pasando en Estados Unidos, and you know what? And I understand why they did it, and I agree with them. But they came out with Black Lives Matter. A lot of them were getting shot and killed. You know, the majority. Let's just say maybe they weren't justified shootings, but you know, it was happening, estaba pasando. Muchos de ellos salieron con un que las vidas de nuestros hermanos negritos importan. And every time I think about that, and I read stuff like this, cuando leo cosas como estas, en la kingdom of God, en el reino de Dios, all lives matter. Todas las vidas son de importancia. We all matter to God. Todos le importamos a Dios. He cares for all of us. Todos nosotros le conservamos a Él. That's why he says it in those simple words. Lo dice en esas palabras sencillas. Cast all your anxieties upon him. Dice, dale todas tus ansiedades a él. Because he cares. Wow, what a short statement. Qué declaración tan pequeña, tan poderosa. And I like that word cast. You know why I like it? Because I'm really a rookie fisherman. I've only been fishing like 3 times in my life. But when I think of the word cast, cuando pienso en esa palabra, cast, you know what I think of? The few times I've been to the lake, cuando ha ido al lago, and I cast my line, you know, what does it do? You know what I'm saying? Es lo que haces cuando vas a pescar. Is that a good fishing rod, son? And that's what I think of. So when the Bible tells me to cast all my anxieties on Him, amen, que yo viente todas mis ansiedades a Él, that's what I think about. You know, okay, he, just cast them. Cast it. Just. And go. You know what? He knows what to do next. Él sabe que es el siguiente paso. You don't have to worry about what to do next. Why? Because the Bible is telling us not to worry. Okay, I give it to Jesus, but what am I going to do now? You're going to stop worrying. That's what you're going to do. Ya se lo di a Jesús, pero ya le di mis preocupaciones a Jesús, pero ahora me preocupo. ¿Para qué voy a hacer? Esperar a Jesús. Just wait on Him. He knows what to do better than you and I any day, any time. Él sabe qué hacer cualquier día mejor que tú y que yo. He knows what's best for each and every one of us as an individual. Él sabe qué es lo que es mejor para nosotros como individuos. He knows that. You know, with my wife and I, con mi esposa y yo, he doesn't deal with us the same. No trata con nosotros igual. She has her personal relationship with him. I have mine. Ella tiene su relación personal con él. Yo tengo la mía. And I kind of had to find that out the hard way. Why? Because I expected a lot of things from my wife because, you know, that was me. Yo esperaba muchas cosas de mi esposa porque eso era yo. And then she expected things from me because that was her. And then we both came to find out, los dos venimos a la cuenta that our relationship with Jesus is personal. Nuestra relación con Jesús es personal. Our growth is different. Nuestro crecimiento es diferente. Our level of maturity at times is different. Nuestro nivel de madurez es diferente en veces. Why? Because she has a personal relationship with Jesus. Porque ella tiene una relación personal con Jesús en su lugar. Yo también. So I can't expect certain things from her because that's not her relationship. No puedo esperar ciertas cosas de ellas porque de ella, porque esa no es la relación de ella. La relación de ella es diferente, es diferente de mi and vice versa y viceversa. So what do? ¿Qué hacemos? She takes her relationship with Jesus and I take my relationship with Jesus. Yo agarro mi relación con Jesús y ella agarra la de ella. We put them together and we serve God as a couple. Si bien esperamos un caso, recibimos a Dios con una pareja. That's the way it works. And sadly, tristemente, I've counseled people, and that's one of their biggest problems. Aconsejado gente, es uno de sus problemas mayores.